Thanks for tuning in to Sustainable Practice and Cocinando con Mirna. I'm Jeanette, and this is Mirna. All right, today she's going to make a black bean soup. So it takes a bunch of ingredients, including cilantro, oregano, garlic, onions, etc., etc., etc. You'll see.
El cual lleva un sofrito que yo preparo, que es lo muelo. Lleva un cuarto de cebolla, de una cabeza de cebolla, la pico en un cuatro y uso un cuarto. Tres dientes de ajo, dos ajíes de los pequeños, dos ajíes. Le echo orégano, más o menos esta medida de orégano. La sal, una cucharada. Pimienta al gusto. Y lleva cilantro al gusto de ustedes. Según el gusto que quieran usar de cilantro. Hay personas que no les gusta mucho el cilantro. Y aceite, un cuarto.
Ok. So déjame decírselos a ellos. ¿Cuánto tiempo tú hierves los frijoles más o menos? ¿Los hierves primero al principio
o no? Sí, claro. Los frijoles se ablandan hasta que se ponen a ablandar. Cuando el agua está hirviendo, lavas bien los frijoles, los pones a ablandar y ya cuando uno ve que están blanditos...
¿Cómo los revisas que estén blanditos?
Cojo una cuchara.
¿Y más o menos cuánto se demora? ¿Media hora?
No, según el tipo de frijoles en la olla que usted lo cocina, porque si es un...
So, si es un frijol negro en una olla como esta...
En una hora, se demora una hora.
Una hora, okay. So, with the black beans, you get the dried black beans and you put them in a... If you put them in a traditional pot, then what you do is you boil the water and you leave it in there and it takes about an hour with a traditional. If you use like an Instapot, then it's different, okay? So she'll boil the beans until they're soft. So at about an hour, she goes in, she grabs a spoon, and she does a little taste. If the bean is soft, then she's good to go. From there, she'll let us know how she does it, but the ingredients that she's got prepared for the beans are, she loves using cilantro, so she uses about half a cup of cilantro. She uses about a third, maybe even less than a third cup of olive oil. She's kind of conservative because she tries to be pretty healthful. All right, and she makes this, we call it sofrito in Spanish. It's kind of like a combination of different flavors where she puts in about a 3/4 tablespoon of oregano. She puts in about a tablespoon of salt. Okay, maybe a little less. And then she uses pepper to taste, usually about a teaspoon or 2 teaspoons, and blends everything together with about 2 bell peppers. Okay, but it really depends on you. If you use the bell peppers, if you really like it peppery, then you use 2. If not, you can use less. Okay.
Ahora vamos a empezar a hacer el sofrito para ponérselo a los frijoles. Se incorpora el aceite.
So she puts in her olive oil, a little less than a third cup of olive oil, in a skillet.
El sofrito ya preparado que se ha molido.
The minced ingredients that she put together with the bell peppers, onions, and garlic.
La sal.
She adds her tablespoon of salt. Perhaps a little less than a tablespoon, if you prefer. So now she lets everything kind of warm up in the skillet so that she can put it all together for the black beans that have been boiled.
Aquí están ya los frijoles blanditos.
So the beans are nice and soft there. So now she will add a laurel leaf to.
Ahora le incorporamos
to the sofrito.
El sofrito ya esperamos que hierva ahí hasta que espese y coja todos los sabores.
Now she's left it all together to kind of heat up and marry. And that's essentially it. Eso es todo, ¿verdad?
Eso es lo que llevan los frijoles. A dejarlo ahí que cocinen, espesen para que cojan los sabores. Y queda riquísimo.
¿Ya? A probarlo. Vamos a ver. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. Qué rico. Mm-hmm. Thank you for tuning in. That was the infamous black bean soup by Mirna. We will place down below the description of the ingredients so you guys can do this at home. And Mirna?
Bueno, hasta otro día. Bye bye.